Thank you. In honor of our last district home game, the basketball coaching staff would like to congratulate the freshman, junior varsity, and varsity teams for their success during the 2022-2023 season. These young men have put in many hours and worked hard since October 26th. We know the commitment of these men would not be possible without the support of their parents. Parents, we appreciate your commitment to this program. The hours you have spent taking these young men to and from practice, supporting your athlete during competition, and your support of our program have not gone unnoticed. We would like to thank you all for a great season. After today, our seniors will compete on the Whiteface court one last time as they near the end of their career as a Whiteface basketball player. It is with great pleasure to honor our senior players, senior managers, senior student trainer, and their parents today. Our first senior is one of our two managers, Karen Cervantes. Karen is being escorted by her parents, Jorge and Laura Cervantes. This is Karen's first year as a manager for the varsity team. She has been on the varsity softball team for the past 3 years. Next year, Karen plans on attending Amarillo College for nursing to become a travel nurse. Her most memorable moments from this year was getting to cheer on the boys and be there for them for every win and loss. Also, the time we were coming back from Portales, her, Miriam, and Coach Loftus taught Coach Bell's daughter, younger daughter, how to tie her shoes. Thank you, Karen. Our next senior is our second manager, Miriam Ramirez. Miriam is being escorted by her parents, Ted and Zulema Ramirez. Like Karen, this is her first time being a part of the varsity basketball team. After high school, Miriam plans to go to Texas Tech University and major in nursing to become a registered nurse. Her most memorable moment from this year was when her and Karen messed up the whole scorebook at our first game after telling Coach Loftus they knew how to do the book. Thank you, Miriam. Our next senior is Keaton Paschal. Keaton is being escorted by his parents, Lewis and Brenda Paschal. Keaton is an athletic trainer and has aided Hereford varsity basketball for 4 years. Keaton plans on attending South Plains College next year to get his associate's degree. Keaton's most memorable moment came during his sophomore year when we were at halftime and Coach Loftus broke his glasses. So now he hands his glasses to the managers before halftime. His advice for younger athletes is, never give up on your dreams because you never know how close you are to achieving your goals. Thank you, Keaton. The next senior is 6'7 post Dayton Delosier. Dayton is being escorted by his parents, Don and Michelle Delosier. This is Dayton's second year on the varsity, and he played on the team last year that made it to the regional semifinals. Dayton is involved in many activities outside of basketball, which include choir, 4-H, FFA, Future Farmers of America, as well as being a member of the National Honor Society. After high school, Dayton plans to go to WT and study for a general agriculture degree. His most memorable moment was the team bonding at the Texas Tech basketball game this year and rooming with his teammates during the tournament season. Dayton's advice for younger athletes is, never give up and don't quit, because trust me, there are going to be days after you lose where you don't want to be at practice. Have a positive mindset, even if your teammates don't. Thank you, Dayton. Next senior is 6'7 post Jaden Fletcher. Fletcher is being escorted by his mom, Shonda Bentley. Fletcher has been on varsity for 2 years and was on the regional semifinals team from last year. Outside of basketball, Fletcher is involved with student council as a treasurer and has been the class president all 4 years of high school. He too is a member of the National Honor Society. Fletcher plans on attending Texas Tech next year and studying the medical field. His most memorable moment was when him and Butter had a contest to see who could eat more street tacos at his team dinner. Fletch only won by one. His advice for younger athletes is, it's just not a team, it's your family. and Devin Gonzalez. Hayden is a 6'3" guard forward and is escorted by his parents, Raymond Gonzalez and Lori Coronado. Hayden has been on the varsity for 2 years. He assisted on the run last year to the regional tournament. Hayden plans to attend Texas Tech University next year and pursue a degree in architecture. Hayden's most memorable moment was making it to the regional tournament last year, and he hopes to create a new one by going further this year. His advice for younger athletes is, don't try to be perfect. Just try to be better than you were yesterday. Constantly work on yourself and never give up. Devin is a 6'4 guard forward and is also being escorted by his parents, Raymond Gonzalez and Lori Coronado. Devin has been on varsity for 3 years. He was on the regional quarterfinals team as a sophomore, and his junior year helped lead us to the regional semifinals. Last year, he was all-district honorable mention. Devin plans to attend Texas Tech University next year and pursue a degree in business. Devin's most memorable moment was when he went on a 17-game win streak this year, and it was a blast. His advice for younger athletes is, keep working hard. Things are going to be tough, and things aren't going to go your way sometimes, but you have to keep fighting and never give up. Thank you, boys. Our last senior is 6-foot guard Kenyon Loftus, AKA Butter. Kenyon is being escorted by his parents, Marcus and Crystal Loftus. Kenyon has been on the varsity for 2 years. He was also a part of last year's team that made it to the regional tournament. Kenyon is a member of the National Honor Society. It's a recurring thing that all these guys are all a part of the National Honor Society. It shows how much work they put into academics as well as athletics. After high school, Kenyon would like to continue playing basketball and pursue a career in law. Kenyon's most memorable moment was getting MVP this year at the Grand Tournament. His advice for younger athletes is, do the little things that no one else is willing to do. Thank you, Butter. And here are your seniors for the 2022-23 season. Thank you, boys.
Canté mirando el pasado, peleando por tu voz, caí en la parte que dice adiós, adiós. No pude vivir con todo mi corazón, quería cambiar tu rostro como empezó. Dejé lo que me gustaba, quité lo que me dolía. Feliz.
You're listening to Hereford Whiteface Sports on KPAN-AM-FM, kpanradio.com, and the Live 365 radio app on KPAN Station. Tonight's game is brought to you by the Hereford brand, Capital Farm Credit, Amarillo College, Gooden Fuels, First Bank Southwest, Hereford Regional Medical Center, McDonald's, First Financial Bank, Hereford Independent School District, Stevens 5-Star Car and Truck Center, First National Bank, DevSmith Electric Cooperative, Bob's Heating and Air, Happy Bank, WT Services, Prairie Insurance, Mendez and Mullins Family Funeral Home, Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union, and Matt Silva State Farm Insurance.
Whiteface Gym, where the Hereford Whiteface is trying to get in the basketball playoffs tonight against the Perryton Rangers in what would be a most important game for both these teams. We are tied currently. Each are 5-7 in the district. The winner tonight, although not officially, unofficially, I think, will be the fourth place seed out of the district. Whiteface is with the game here tonight and Tuesday night at Borger against Borger. Wins in both of those, and the Whitefaces would be the outright finishers of fourth place, and again move on to the playoffs, likely against Seminole. The girls, of course, are already in the playoffs, and they will play Seminole on Monday night, 6:30 down in Lubbock, and we'll be there to broadcast that as the Lady Whitefaces try to advance into round two of the basketball playoffs against the district champs from down south. Here are the two teams right on the field. We had a long JV game that went into overtime. Whiteface guys won it by 5 in overtime. And then we've had senior night here tonight. So the senior three trainers, and then the senior players all introduced along with their parents a moment ago. And it was a nice evening, big crowd here at the gym. And glad you could join us for the broadcast here tonight. Coach Kitten is getting all set up, ready to go here, as we are, and we're going to take a 60-second break. Right back to Daniel. We'll be back here courtside in 1 minute.
Since 1901, the Hereford brand has been keeping readers informed and entertained with all things Hereford. A weekly historical column, detailed recaps of city and county government meetings, and photos of your favorite Herd athlete or youngster fishing in the pond. Things have changed some since the early days, like being able to get the paper sent straight to your email. But some things have stayed the same, like providing local content you need to read. The Hereford brand, back in downtown Hereford, across from the courthouse.
Well, there's nothing like the sound of a new baby calf or the smell of fresh rain on a cotton crop. My friends at Capital Farm Credit share this excitement with agricultural and livestock producers. We want to be your lending partner. Whether you require operating funds for next year's crop or need to buy hay for your cattle, we have a loan that's right for you. Let us finance your operation. CapitalFarmCredit.com.
All right, the Whitefaces and the Rangers warming up here. They're the only Rangers I think I know of, and I'm not sure. Are there Rangers elsewhere in state? There probably are. Yeah, there are. I know another school that is. There's not many Rangers. We're in a land, I mean, where I grew up in East Texas, everybody was either a tiger, or a lion, or a wildcat. Out here, you're, you know, a harvester, a Whiteface, a Sandy. I mean, there's a lot of weird school nicknames.
We were Rattlers.
Rattlers?
We were Rattlers. And
all right. Well, there's not many Rattlers.
No, there's not. We played the Brahmas.
Brahmas, yep.
From what I can't remember what San Antonio school that was.
Rattlers and Brahmas. There were Brahmas at Paul Pewitt High School in East Texas. They're Brahmas. I don't know many Brahmas, though, besides that. But anyway, we're in the land of unique nicknames, I guess. So the Whitefaces being one of those, maybe one of the most unique of all. Well, the Whiteface guys need to win here, Coach. We played well. We played well, really, against West Plains. We played well against Randall, and we played well against Canyon, and we got nothing for it.
Yeah, I'm glad we're at home.
Yeah.
It was a tough battle up there. It was a tough first quarter up there.
It was.
Our guys pulled it out. I mean, I'm telling you, win this one, and you're taking care of business.
Yep. Well, we got down 14-0 in Perryton the first time around, and then just righted the ship, came roaring back, and wound up.
I can't remember who their shooter was. I mean,
they had a guy that scored 9 points in the first quarter, and didn't, I think, scored two after that. Is that right? Something like that.
Yep.
In any event, we'll try to get off to a better start here tonight. You're watching at home via the video. Back behind us are Adam and Anastasia. Danielle's up there, too, and they're all very nervous because, I mean.
I don't think they're nervous.
They're going to have to put up or shut up. I mean, the time has come now. As the Eagles go up against the Chiefs, I believe there's one game. That's what a guy wrote years ago, just one game in the NFL this weekend. And there's just one. And it's for all the marbles. Should be a great football game. It really should.
I heard somebody, you know, every one of those sports pundits, they've got their own opinions. I was listening to one guy, and I don't know. It was on the radio, and I don't know who the guy was, but it is going to be an Eagles blowout. It'll be a terrible, boring game. And he thought it was going to be just an Eagles blowout.
You sure that wasn't Adam?
Maybe it was. Maybe it was on the phone with Adam.
I think that's what Adam said. They're not even listening. Golly, we're talking about y'all, and they're not even listening. We've wasted all this. They've been sitting back up here eating, and Adam predicted a blowout. An Eagles win by 28 points is what he predicted. That's what we heard. So, in any event, there is a game this weekend between the Eagles and the Chiefs. And it, I saw yesterday, I believe they said from the time that they come out on the field, it's like a 40-minute wait. And then, of course, the halftime, I love Super Bowl halftime. I mean, first of all, they've got somebody I could care less to hear sing, and then they're out there for an hour and a half.
I was reminded that when she came by here out at Cadillac Ranch, she wrote some really unkind things out there.
Oh, did she?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no.
Yep. And
Wow.
But it's another one of those sports guys. He's like, I don't know her songs. I know, like, because they were trying to say, oh, what's the first one going to be? What's the second song? What's she going to end with? You know, so they play a little snippet, and he says, oh, yeah, I've heard it, but I don't know who sings that. And so
that's good. I'm with him.
How I feel, too. I
heard her say she's got 13 minutes, and it's hard to decide what to put into 13 minutes. And I suggested maybe we don't have a halftime, and that would be, you know, then that way you wouldn't have to decide. But
well, is Chris Stapleton singing the national anthem?
I think so, yeah.
He'll take 13 minutes to sing that.
Well, I just said a moment ago, I think there's 40 minutes from the time they come out until the game starts. It's some ridiculous something like that. So the officials are lined up over there, 1, 2, 3. I mean, Israel being the shortest of the three. And then we go up and up until Ricky Guy wins the tallest of the three award.
So he called a JV.
I thought that's what was probably going to happen. He has called a JV to get warmed up. Ricky Guy, a golfer of some note and a basketball coach of some note, and a heart transplant recipient, which is probably his greatest feat of all, despite all the other things. Having someone else's heart beating in you for, I bet it's been 10 years now, and out here calling ball games. It's pretty amazing.
Wow.
Pretty amazing. Well, the Whiteface is, again, we know what they've got. They know what we've got. We know what happened up there, how we got behind, how we fought back. That was one of the games that Kenyon missed, I believe.
I think that was the last one that he missed.
Entirely. But we came back, and I think, if I remember right, Duque scored 22 or something that night. What did he score?
Yep, he had 22, and both Zevin and Jaden had 10 apiece. Jaden had a great third quarter. Yep. He ended up with 8 in that third quarter. And, we just had a rough as heck first quarter. 9 points to their, gosh, what did they have?
20.
20, yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, they got up on us, and then we fought back, and we were down by 7 at the half, tied it up at the end of 3, and kind of won it going away. But, boy, it didn't seem like it when you were there for the whole thing. Evening, sir. How are you?
How are you?
One of the refs just dropping by to visit with us there a moment. Well, let's take another. We'll wait here. Well, what else is going on with the ladies' play at 6:30? We're at Lubbock Christian.
Lubbock Christian against Seminole.
Nice venue.
Yes, they always treat us very, very well there. The LCU treats us well. We haven't been treated real well by our opponents over the years. But
In basketball.
In basketball.
We've done all right in volleyball. Yeah. We haven't played there many times. But, yeah.
It's a great facility. They've got such a good basketball basketball program, and they do a really nice job. Very, very thorough. Take care of all the details. You just show up, and they got you covered.
My face is off to our right here, gathering around Coach Loftus. And Coach Loftus and Ty trying to figure out which basketball they want to play with. Got two. Now we can't decide. All right, here we go. He drops that one. Let's see if he's going to drop the other one. Ty says this one here. So that's the one we play with. Golly, I never got to pick the basketball when I played. I don't know why.
My coach most of the time said you don't need the basketball in your hands.
That's good. Big crowd here for the boys game here, the regular season finale for the guys in maroon and white. And we're going to take a break to the studios. Back to Daniel.
And at number 0, junior,
we're not going to go back. I guess we're going to keep it here. We're not going to play the national anthem, or we're going to play it after this.
Number 1, senior.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Well, right now they're introducing. Claudia's got it done. We are introducing the Perryton Rangers at this moment.
Number 5, sophomore guard Britt Blackshear.
Britt Blackshear.
And number 31, senior forward, Tad Shigoda.
Tad Shigoda, that's the starters. Tarango. I'm missing a couple. Channel 10's getting video of us here tonight.
And now, the starting lineup.
Yeah, we appreciate them being here.
Yeah, we do. Don't let me forget, I'm supposed to send him the scores after the game. All right, Devin Gonzalez, the first of the Whiteface players out.
Number 4, senior guard, Kenyon Loftus.
Kenyon Loftus, those two guys playing their final game here.
Number 5, senior on the home floor, forward, Hayden Gonzalez.
Hayden Gonzalez, another of the seniors playing for the
Number
final time.
Number 11, sophomore guard, Ty Duque.
Ty Duque.
And number 42, senior post, Jaden
Fletcher, that's the starting five for the maroon and white.
We heard of Coach Mark, Marcus Falkus, and we're gonna... by Tim Bell, Hunter Garza, and Peyton Gonzalez. Thank you, Claudia, and enjoy the game.
Claudia's looking for another career.
Claudia's into this PA stuff. Wow.
Are we going to be able to keep her coaching here? Is she going to go on the road?
Championship wrestling.
With her skills?
Whitefaces and Rangers on the floor, ready to go. The Rangers, I missed Rigdon. And who was the other starter that I failed to call a moment ago? Cervantes.
There you go.
Cervantes is really the guy. I've noticed scores along. He scored 24 the other night against Randall. Of course, that same night, Thomas of Randall scored 35, so... Here we go, Fletcher and Shigoda tip back to, comes to Perryton. The Rangers have the ball, this game underway.
Uh-oh.
They shoot a 3 from the near side. It is nowhere near the mark. Fletcher up to get the rebound, back the other way we go. Well, that's the guy that couldn't miss in Perryton. He missed bad there. In the forecourt now, left side pass goes off to Zevin. Zevin out to the top of the circle now to Hayden. Hayden gives it off to Duque. Ty works right and left. Spins in the lane, can't find anybody, brings it back out. Now he gets a little screen from Fletcher. Goes to the right, down low, he's fouled, he'll shoot 2. 2 free throws now. Coach Loftus talking to Butter, Kenyon, his son, but Butter is what they all call him because he's just as smooth.
Well, it's because his sister could not say brother.
Well, my story sounds better. Ty shooting two here on the first possession of the night for the White Faces, makes the first one. 1-0 Hereford, 7:23 left, first quarter of play. White Faces and Rangers here tonight. Big crowd at Whiteface Gym. Sure glad it's them having to drive home after the game and not us. Oh. Ty made them both. 2-0 Hereford, full court pressure. In the backcourt, Shigota's got it. He starts up the floor, Hayden on him. Midcourt, he passes over here to Rigdon. Rigdon ahead to Shigota in the corner. They shoot another three, it's no good. Rebound tipped out of bounds by Perryton.
Oh.
He pointed, said White, but it should have been Perryton's ball, and it is, as they correct it. Inbounds now it comes to Cervantes. In the lane, Rigdon, turnaround jumper, no good. Rebound Fletcher. Fletcher to Butter, and here we go. Across the midcourt line, he comes, passes in the corner now to Zevin. Zevin, down low. Duque can't shoot, passes back outside and throws it away. Ty got trapped down there, and he could have shot, I think, but he was trying to do the unselfish thing, and it turned out to be a turnover. 6:54 left, first quarter, 2-0 Hereford. Cervantes all the way, left-handed layup is good. We're tied at two. Hereford back the other direction now as Duque comes across midcourt. On his right is Kenyon. Left is Zevin. Perryton in the man-to-man. Top of the circle pass. Down low, we throw it away. Tried to get it into Fletcher and kind of forced it. Here comes Rigdon. Shigota, I beg your pardon. It's 4-2 now in favor of the Rangers. Kenyon back the other way. 6:24 left, first quarter. Kenyon trapped on the baseline. Scoops it off the glass. Fletcher misses the rebound. And the ball goes back to Perryton. Wow. Perryton here in the forecourt gets tripped up. Still has the ball, throws it down low, shot up, and a foul on Hayden Gonzalez. Two free throws for, a charge.
They're calling that on Shigota.
They did. Shigota with a charge. And the White Faces get the ball down 4-2.
Wow. We need to take notes.
Yep. Back the other way now. Comes Hayden. High post pass goes to Fletcher. In the corner now, back to Zevin. Kenyon's got it. Rigdon has him. Now he passes back to Hayden. Hayden drives in the lane, lays it up and in. We're tied at four. Nice move, Hayden Gonzalez. 5:45 left, first quarter. Perryton with the ball against full court pressure. Ball intercepted by Hayden, or by Zevin. Left-handed layup is good. 6-4 Hereford. Whiteface pressure gets the turnover and the bucket. Up the floor now, Cervantes. Throws it in the corner. They shoot the three. Missed the three. Hayden with the rebound. Back the other way come the White Faces. Up 6-4. 5:21 left in the quarter. Inside Fletcher. 8-4. White Faces by four. Great pass into Fletcher. White Faces up with 5:12 left in the first quarter. Rigdon in the backcourt. Fires it ahead now. Almost threw it away. They get it back. Shoot the three and make. Nope. No good again. But the rebound inside. Back out. They'll shoot another three. It's no good. Rebound off to out of bounds off of Hereford. 8-4 White Faces, 4:55. Man, Perryton is putting up the threes, aren't they?
They are.
Wow. White Faces with Lopez in and DeLozier in, and Hayden and Fletcher come out. Racehorse basketball here. The White Faces up 8-4. Inbounds, Cervantes has got it. Left side, Rigdon shoots a three. It is good. 8-7. Inbounds in the backcourt for the White Faces now. Duque up the court. 4:42 left in the period. 8-7 Hereford lead. On the outside, Duque's got it. He goes inside, passes off in the corner. Three-point shot by Lopez is no good. Back the other way comes Cervantes. 2-on-1. Knocked away, intercepted by Kenyon. Hereford with an advantage, gets it off on the baseline now to Duque. He has it knocked away, and the ball comes back to Perryton. Long lead pass, Perryton behind us, and they make the layup. That's Alvarez. Perryton back on top, 9-8. 4:09 left in the first quarter. Lopez up the floor. Cross midcourt now, right side pass to Duque. On the outside, he's guarded by Blackshear. Starts right, then left. Back right, now goes in the lane, passes to Kenyon. Kenyon steps back, shoots a three, it's no good. Rebound inside, tipped out of bounds by the Whitefaces. 3:45 left in the quarter, 9-8. Perryton on top. Duque out, Gonzalez, Brandon Gonzalez in. In the backcourt now, the Rangers will inbound it. It is Rigdon to put it in play. Rigdon inbounds it to Cervantes, back to Rigdon. Rigdon now comes up near midcourt with Zevin on him, across midcourt, fires it to Cervantes, who travels, and Hereford gets it back. Cervantes with a little head fake, and he didn't put it on the floor. 9-8, Whiteface is down by one with the ball. In the backcourt, Brandon Gonzalez and Lopez. Now it's Loftus with the ball as he comes across the midcourt. Again, Blackshear has him. Outside now to Brandon. Brandon looking down low, can't find anyone, gets it to Lopez. Lopez comes open, fires it down to Brandon. Great pass, 10-9. Hereford on top by one. Great pass by Lopez there. Or by, yeah, Lopez. Here is Cervantes in the forecourt, pulls up in the lane, misses the shot, but draws the foul. He'll shoot two with 3:07 left in the quarter, and the Whitefaces leading 10-9.
First foul for the Whitefaces.
Comes on Lopez.
Tell you what, 3:07 left, play 5 minutes. Woo, that's a long time for the Whitefaces.
Free throw is good. We're tied at 10. Cervantes can put the Rangers ahead. Hayden back in for the Whitefaces. Out comes Zevin. Gonna have to give guys some breathers here tonight. This is pretty frantic pace, both teams. One more free throw for Cervantes now. 10-10 game, 3:07 left. First quarter, he makes it. 11-10. The lead belongs to the Rangers as Brolin brings it up. Loses the ball, but gets it back. Needs some help. Now gets it to Kenyon. Kenyon in the corner to Lopez, down the baseline, pulls up, jumps, misses. Rebound Rangers. And in the backcourt now, it's Cervantes with Lopez on him. Cervantes dribbles through the double team. Whitefaces whistle for a foul with 2:44 left in the quarter. Second foul against Hereford. Duque back in, Lopez out. The foul is on Lopez, and that's two on him.
Yep.
We got the double team here at midcourt, but Lopez reached in, got the whistle, and the ball back to the Rangers. They have a one-point lead in the basketball with 2:40 left in the first quarter. Cervantes on the outside now. Tie on him. Goes to his left, passes off now over on the left side to Tarango. Tarango brings it back out. He goes right, bounces it down the right side. Here's a three-point shot by Cervantes. It's no good. The rebound belongs to Brandon Gonzalez. Hereford back the other way. Brandon all the way, fires it out from the corner. Three-point shot spins in and out. Tipped out by Brandon. We've got a whistle after the play, and the foul, I think, is going to be on, yep, the Rangers on Samples. He pulls Delosier down. Whitefaces get the ball back. A one-point deficit, 2:10 left in the first quarter. Inbounds from Kenyon, comes to Delosier. He loses the handle, gets it back, out to Brandon. Kenyon for three, it's no good. Rebound out, though, to Lopez. Ball's kicked, it's Hereford's ball. Well, we can't find the range yet on a three, but we will. We're down 11-10, 2:02 left in the first quarter.
Get him out of the way right now.
Yep. Right side down, Hayden's got it inside. He throws it away. It'll be Rangers ball. Duque might have gotten shoved there as he went for the basketball. 1:56 left in the quarter, 1-point lead for the Rangers. They've got the ball in the backcourt, full court pressure for the Whitefaces. Rigdon will inbound it, and he does so in the backcourt to Tarango. Tarango with Brandon on him, comes across midcourt. Foul on Brandon. Oh, that's our third. Well, we better learn here tonight. Don't be reaching in. Three fouls against the Whitefaces. A minute 50 left in the first quarter. Again, ball belongs to the Rangers. For the Rangers, it's Cervantes. Right side pass now to Rigdon, out to Tarango. Tarango gives it off to Blackshear. Back it goes. Ball's knocked away, but Perryton gets it back. Inside, going to call a foul on, golly, bum. Going to call a foul on Duque, his first, the team's fourth. We haven't been playing in games like this, and we better get ourselves adjusted. Inbounds now for Perryton, a minute 30 left in the quarter. On the outside, left side, long three by Rigdon is no good. Rebound to Perryton. Reverse layup is no good, and Duque gets the rebound. Back the other way comes Ty. We're down by a point. 1:16 left first quarter. Here's Zevin out on the point. He gives it back to Ty. Ty around the right side. Needs some help. Gets it back out to Zevin. 1:05 left in the quarter. Zevin around. Boy, wow, Zevin really getting banged. Back out front to Hayden in the corner now. Open for a three. It's up. It's no good again. Rebound Zevin. Ball out of bounds and still loose, and it belongs to the Whitefaces. 48 seconds left. In the corners, Zevin drives inside. Wow. And Coach, you hear Coach Loftus saying, get him off. And, I mean, really, if we're going to call what we've called here at midcourt. 11-10, Perryton, 44 seconds left first quarter. Well, it's hard to kind of figure this one out at the moment. Inbounds now to Rigdon. 11-10, they lead. 41 seconds left, first quarter. Rigdon across midcourt. On the outside, Ty has him. Rigdon keeps it, steps back, wants to shoot, can't. Inside now, contact, the bucket's good. Bucket by Cervantes. 13-10 lead for the Rangers. 21 seconds left in the period. Ty outside now to Hayden. Hayden spins. Goes back right, then left to the bucket. He's fouled. He'll shoot two. 11 seconds left in the first period. Hayden Gonzalez to the line. Whiteface is trailing 13-10. Again, the winner of this game is in a really good position to go into the playoffs. First free throw is no good. I should say if we win the game. I don't think that's true. They have Canyon left to play, so no guarantees for Perryton. Second free throw is good. 13-11.
Chance, chance of a tie if the worst were to happen for the Whitefaces today.
Yeah.
Pretty good chance that they could be tied at the end of just.
Could be multiple tires, too. There's a couple of teams beneath us. Inbounds, Whitefaces tried to steal it, but don't. 9-9 left in the quarter. We trail by two. Perryton inbounds the ball in the backcourt. Tarango. And there's a charge. Charge on Shigota, his second foul.
Third
foul.
I think it's his third, yeah.
It is his third, wow.
Quarter number one.
So the one of the leading scorers for Perryton is in foul trouble. We've got the ball with 7 seconds left in the quarter. Perryton coach going crazy. Inbounds now outside. The ball's out of bounds off of Perryton. 5.5 seconds left in the first period. 13-11 lead for the Rangers. Whiteface is now ready to put it in play. Inbounds it comes to Duque. He turns and shoots a three. It's off the front of the iron. Quarter ends and the Whitefaces lead it, or trail it, I beg your pardon, 13-11. Back at Whiteface Gym in 1 minute.
Start here, AC. Go anywhere. Amarillo College is the place to prepare. AC.
I wanted to be a nurse for years. Amarillo College helped me get there. I had a job lined up even before I graduated. With my degree from AC, I can go anywhere and do anything.
Trust your future to a college that cares. Start here, AC. Go anywhere.
Your business, farm and ranch, or home is unique, and success depends in part on a cost-effective and convenient supply of quality fuel. When you trust your fueling needs to Gooden Fuels, it's one less detail for you to manage. Commercial fuel in bulk in below ground or above ground tanks, serving the Western Panhandle with gasoline, diesel, and propane. Gooden Fuels in Hereford, 364-3366.
All righty, back here for quarter number two, 13-11. Perryton leads after one period, and Hereford will have the ball to begin the second quarter.
Mr. Hedrick back here, Sarah, having to take care of our camera guy. He's taking pictures and got the camera just jammed up against his brow. Oh.
Hereford's basketball at midcourt as we begin the second quarter. Loftus to put it in play to Duque. Zevin and Hayden and Fletch out there. Outside now, Duque back on the right side to Zevin. Looking inside, trying to find somebody cutting through. Can't find anybody, brings it back out to the bucket. Off it goes to Duque for about a 15-footer. It's good, and the Whiteface is tied up. 7:37 left in the half in a 13-13 ball game. Inbounds now, Rigdon quickly across midcourt all the way. Rigdon, shot blocked by Fletcher. Duque comes up with a loose ball. Back the other way come the Whiteface. Duque gives it now to Hayden. Hayden back to Duque on the outside. He penetrates. He's fouled. 7:17 left in the quarter. 13-13 ball game. That's the fifth foul against the Rangers. Whiteface basketball. Inbound from Kenyon. It comes to down low to Fletcher. He goes up. Can't score. Ball's loose. Perryton ball. Trying to get in there to the big guy, but Perryton denied him there. Rangers quickly down the floor. Ball knocked away. Hayden comes up with it. Good play by Hayden. Off to Zevin. Zevin has the shot blocked. It'll be Herbert's ball. Now, that was a technical foul the other night, but not tonight. Cervantes blocks the shot and turns around and stares down Zevin. 13 all game. Inbounds down low. Ball's out of bounds. Off of Herbert. Man, there was a lot of contact there. It's really getting really, really rough. 6:58 left in the half. Rigdon has the inbounds pass. He comes up near midcourt, throws it ahead now to Cervantes. Cervantes down in the corner to Blackshear. Blackshear back out to Cervantes. 6:46 till the half. We're tied at 13. Cervantes shoots it in the lane and scores. Wow, a little runner there. About 8 feet away, and it's 15-13 Perryton. 6:38 till the half. Duque outside. Duque to Zevin. Zevin to Hayden. Hayden to Fletcher. Fletcher has it knocked away, and Perryton comes up with the ball. Back the other way is Alvarez. Alvarez off to Cervantes. He misses the three. The rebound outlet pass comes out here to Kenyon. Kenyon starts to the bucket. Stops, shoots, misses. Rebound tied up. It'll be Perryton's ball. Well, we had what we wanted, but we couldn't get the bucket. Alvarez gets up limping. He got the worst of that collision with Fletcher in the backcourt now. Rigdon, 6:04 left in the half. Knocked away by Zevin, and he's fouled by Rigdon. It'll be a 1-1 for the Whiteface. Trailing 15-13, 1-1 free throws now for Zevin Gonzalez.
Too long, Rigdon.
The pressure has gotten, I mean, we've gotten some good pressure on Perryton, but they've also played some good defense. And they lead 15-13 as Zevin steps to the line. The senior shooting a 1-1. That was the seventh foul on Perryton, 4 on the Whitefaces. Up it goes, in it goes. 15-14, he makes it a 1-point game. Zevin can tie it up. This is the starting five for the Whitefaces. Out here right now, 6 minutes left in the first half. Again, big crowd here tonight for this one. Monday night, Lady Whitefaces, he makes them both. Whitefaces tied up. Again, full court pressure. Zevin inbounds to Tarango. Tarango with Hayden on him at midcourt. Stops his dribble, but gets it ahead to Cervantes. Cervantes splits the double team, loses the ball, still loose. Perryton's Blackshear comes up with it, shoots on the baseline, misses. They get the rebound, shoot a three, misses. Rebound inside Fletcher, and Fletcher now to Hayden. Hayden up the floor for the Whitefaces. Long pass ahead. Duque saves it in the corner. Duque looking inside, trying to find somebody. Goes in the lane. Off to Hayden. Hayden travels. 15 all, 5:24 left first half. Well, I'll tell you, they are on us pretty close, Coach, without much whistling going on. 15 all, full court pressure. Cervantes, now a timeout call by Perryton. With 5:24 left in the half, we'll take a 30-second break. We're all tied up at 15, back in 1.5 minutes.
For generations, First Bank Southwest has been there to help the working hands that have shaped this great land. Chances are we helped your father, and even his father. We understand for some, a handshake is a stronger bond than a piece of paper. And even though times can be tough, folks around here are tougher. And that's why we're as proud of our Panhandle roots as you are. First Bank Southwest, moving your generation in the right direction. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
All righty, 15 all is the score here at Whiteface Gym, Hereford and Perryton in a most important basketball game for both teams.
Don't you get the feeling already that this thing is going to come down to the bitter end?
I hope not, but I do, yes. Mm. Perryton's ball here as we go back to play, 5:24 left in the first half. Again, a torrid pace. Duque talking to Perryton player who doesn't want to talk to Duque. In the backcourt now, Cervantes with Kenyon on him. Comes ahead, gets it off to Rigdon, who goes down the baseline, throws it out. They shoot the three. It is no good. Rebound off to Perryton. Ball loose, taken away by Kenyon. Back the other way we go. Three on one. Kenyon off to Hayden. Shot blocked by the Rangers. Back the other way come the Rangers. Two on one. Blackshear misses. Rebound out of bounds off of Perryton. Hereford's ball with 4:55 left in the first half, tied at 15. Wow. Great play by Perryton on the defensive end, and then they miss a layup on the other end. Duque ahead down to Kenyon. Kenyon's not found the range outside yet. Here's Hayden to Kenyon here. Oh, no, he doesn't take the three. Inside to Zevin. Shot blocked. Zevin gets it back. He scores and he's fouled. 17-15. Hereford goes up by two. 4:37 left in the first half, and Zevin Gonzalez a chance to make it a three-point lead. Perryton now bringing Hernandez into the ball game. He's kind of got the Buddy Holly look.
Doesn't
he? He's got some of those black rim glasses.
Mm-hmm.
Diego comes in for Hayden. 4:37 till half. Zevin with a chance now to make it an 18-15 game. It is Loftus, Fletcher, Zevin, Duque, and Villegas. Free throw's good. 18-15, Hereford. Rangers ready to put it in play. Tarango going to get, nope. Now he gets it in bounds to, ball's knocked away, but comes back to Cervantes. He throws it ahead the forecourt to Hernandez. Hernandez cross-court with a pass to Tarango. Tarango outside to Cervantes. 18-15, Hereford, 4:20 left first half. Cervantes drives inside, shoots, and misses. Rebound, Fletcher. Fletcher to Kenyon. Here come the Whitefaces. Quickly in the forecourt now. Kenyon goes to his right. Off to Duque. Duque trying to direct traffic. Does. Throws it into Fletcher. Ball knocked away. Still loose. Gets back to the Whitefaces. And Villegas puts it in. Great play by Duque to keep it alive. Hereford leads 20-15. In the backcourt, Tarango now for the Rangers. Across midcourt. He loses the ball but gets it back. Fires to Cervantes. Cervantes takes it inside. Taken away by Zevin. Back the other way comes Zevin. He goes to the bucket. He shoots and he's fouled by Cervantes with 3:36 left in the first half.
I think they called it.
Oh, they called a charge. They did. I beg your pardon.
Mm-hmm.
Charge on Zevin. 3:36 left in the half. We lead by five. Zevin's first foul tonight. He gets a breather. Hayden and Brandon and Ty. They've got Rigdon trapped, but he gets it ahead to Cervantes. He goes around. There's a foul on Hayden. That's the sixth on the Whitefaces. Comes with 3:28 left in the half, and Hereford leading by five. That's the first foul against Hayden. Rangers ball on the far side. Rigdon to inbound it for the red and white clad Rangers. Inbounds to Cervantes. Duque has him. Cervantes at midcourt. Ty. Right side pass. Now they work it outside. Get it to Blackshear and back to Cervantes. Cervantes in traffic. Throws it in the corner. Good defense by the White Faces. Nice pass by the Rangers. Bucket by Caleb Jones. Back the other way go the White Faces. Brandon with the ball. Hereford with a three-point lead. Left side pass now taken away by the Rangers. Hernandez all the way. He lays it up and in. It's a one-point game. A steal and a bucket for Hernandez. 2:48 left in the half. Brandon in the forecourt to his left, down low. Nice fake by Diego. He puts it off the glass and in. Whitefaces by three. 2:37 left in the half. Back the other way now. Foul on Brandon as they come down the floor. Cervantes winds up on the floor. It'll be a 1-1 for the Rangers, and Cervantes probably the last guy we won't shoot. 22-19 Hereford.
Yeah, I mean, these guys are calling reaching, and you can't reach, and you can't lean. They're going to get you.
There's parts of it that are really rough, and then other parts, that's but 1-1 now for the Rangers or Cervantes. He's good, 22-20. Cervantes is a junior. He's a really good basketball player, good shooter. 2:32 left in the half. He can make it a one-point game, and he does. 22-21 Hereford. Inbounds to Kenyon. Hereford 0 for the half, shooting threes. Kenyon takes it down the left baseline, goes inside. He's fouled. Winds up on the floor, and then we're going to get a technical. Yep. Let's see who the T's on. The foul was on Hernandez initially. And then the officials ran in. They're having a conference now about who the T was on. It could have been on Kenyon. I'm not sure. Let's see what. Technicals on both of them. Kenyon and Hernandez both get technicals. And the White Faces were fouled initially, so we'll shoot the...
I don't know who the initial foul.
The foul, I think Kenyon's the shooter. Kenyon's going to shoot the free throws. Okay, 2:25 left in the half. We lead by one. There were technical fouls on both teams. There was a foul on Kenyon. Then there were technical fouls on Kenyon and on Hernandez. So let's see what we got. Let's see. Try to listen in. Okay, we're not shooting technicals. We'll just shoot the two free throws. And then the ball will belong to them.
They have to, don't they?
I thought so. Kenyon misses. Kenyon missed the first free throw. He'll get a second chance here. Down up 22-21. 2:25 left in the first half. Whiteface is trying to kind of. Kenyon makes this one. Now he comes out. Hayden comes in. Takes a seat on the Whiteface bench. 23-21 score. The White Faces up by two, and it is Perryton's ball. I thought you had to shoot. I did too, but official said no. Inbounds Rigdon in the backcourt. He's trapped there. The ball's knocked away by the White Faces. Great play by Duque. He stole the ball. Timeout, Hereford. And the White Faces have a two-point lead. The ball. What a play by Duque. Knocked it away. Went airborne and kept it inbounds. And the White Faces wind up with the basketball and take a timeout, leading by 2 points. This is pretty frantic, Coach.
Yep, absolutely it is. I'm going to have to do some, I'm going to have to get some schooling on this. Okay. I mean,
I get.
Because some I mean, what if somebody makes one and somebody makes two?
I know. I don't know. If I get a chance, I'll ask one of these guys here in a minute. But there wasn't nobody, neither coach had a problem with it, so I'm sure that's the rule. But I did not know that was the rule. Hereford's ball up by two. We got Hayden and Zevon and Ty and Fletch and Villegas on the floor. And Villegas will inbound it. Diego will on the far side. Officials are all squared away. Foul-wise, that winds up. That's a personal foul, too. I mean, counts as a personal foul. So a foul on each of those guys in addition to the technical foul. Here's Zevon outside. Gives the ball down to Ty. Ty gets a little bit of a screen. He goes in the lane, lays it up. It won't go. Rebound Fletcher outside to Zevon. Off it goes to Diego. He hits a three. 26-21. Whiteface is by five. Up the floor, Diego then fouls Cervantes with a minute 54. Wow. He makes the big three. You hear the question from the bench. Why? And because you get excited, I guess. We lead by five, but two free throws now for Julian Cervantes. He makes the first. It's 26-22. That's nine fouls against Hereford, 10 against against the Rangers. So both teams shooting two the rest of this half. He makes both free throws. In comes Dayton DeLosier. Out goes Fletcher. Hereford up by three with the ball. A minute 54 left in the half. And here comes Ty up the floor. He's picked up by Hernandez. Ty goes to his right, passes down the corner. Ball knocked out of bounds by Rigdon. Still Herford's ball. 1:43 till the intermission. 26-23 Hereford. Inbounds to Ty. Left side now to Hayden. Hayden directing traffic. Gives it back to Ty. Ty has it on the right side outside the three-point line. DeLosier way out front with the ball. Inside, thrown away. DeLosier gets it back. Throws it down low. Shot up, no good. Rebound off to Perryton. Perryton up the floor. This is Cervantes all the way. Cervantes misses. Rebound out of bounds off of Perryton. 1:18 left in the half. Herbert's ball. Three-point ball game. We kind of got away with one there. Perryton had a really good advantage, and Cervantes rushed the shot. Here's Duque outside now. Right side pass to Zevon. Zevon back to Duque. Duque in the lane, scoops it off the glass. He'll draw the foul on Cervantes, and he'll shoot two. 1 minute left in the half. Whitefaces, that is Cervantes' first foul. Whitefaces up 26-23, Ty shooting two free throws. Perryton coach in disbelief on the foul. Sometimes you need to believe. Ty is up and good. 27-23. Whitefaces by four. Another chance for the Whiteface sophomore here. Hereford trying to win and assure themselves of a fourth place finish in the district. Ty puts it up, made them both. 28-23, Hereford by five. 1 minute left in the half. Inbounds now, Cervantes lost it, got it back. Now Rigdon has it. Rigdon up near midcourt. Villegas on him. Goes to his left. Now back right. Passes off on the near side in the lane. Shot up and good.
Whoa.
Hernandez, he had no idea that ball could even go in, but it did. And it counts. 28-25. Duque, 34 seconds left in the half. Out front now, he gives it off to Zevon. Zevon back to Hayden. Hayden back to Zevon. Zevon down the baseline. Pull-up jumper. No good. Rebound off to Hereford. Villegas got it. He got fouled. I think that's Cervantes with 19 seconds left in the half. Two free throws now for Diego Villegas.
On Hernandez, that's his third.
Hernandez, okay. Hernandez's third foul. Wow. Free throws up and good. 29-25. Boy, Diego, he's got a nice touch. He really does. They bring samples out of there. 19 seconds, 19.9 seconds till the intermission. We lead by four, and Diego makes it a five-point game. Inbounds in the backcourt now. Rigdon has it for Perryton. Comes up near midcourt. Oh, he lost the ball. Double dribbles. Hereford gets it back. Rigdon lost the ball and picked it back up. We're up by five, but a chance for a final shot here before intermission time. 30-25, Whiteface's lead. Hayden right here in front of us, going to inbound it. Duque gets the inbounds pass. Heads down in the corner, gives it off to Zevin. Left side pass now to Villegas. Villegas to the bucket, off the glass, no good. Delosier back up, he's fouled. 1.3 seconds left.
Attaboy.
Another foul on the Rangers. 5-point lead now. Dayton can widen the lead. 1.3 seconds left in the half. Whitefaces with the advantage. Perryton with a ton of fouls in this half. They've got two players with three, one with two. Delosier shoots the first of two now for the big senior. Up it goes and softly in. 31-25. Got a chance to put the Whitefaces in the locker room with a 7-point lead. Dayton shoots. Be hard for Perryton to get a shot away here. Of course, the Whitefaces certainly don't want to foul. Dayton makes them both. Inbounds, that's it. Perryton now, as time runs out here at the intermission, with the Whitefaces leading 32-27 in a rock'em sock'em first half of basketball at Whiteface Gym. I'm tired and I'm not playing.
And I'm looking here at 6 for 6 from the free throw line is Perryton. Hereford, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We shot 15 and we've made 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13 or 15.
Wow.
That's it?
That's as good as we can do right
there.
Wow.
That's pretty darn good, isn't it?
32-25, Hereford leads. We'll take a 2-minute timeout, come back and look at the first half scoring at Whiteface Gym in 2 minutes.
Deaf Smith County Hospital District helps our community senior citizens get the most out of life. Our Medicare Wellness Center provides free annual wellness visits for Medicare enrollees. Our team works with you to get up to date on screenings, immunizations, and other preventative care. Together, we review your medical history, assess your risk factors for illness, and discuss ways to reduce risks and promote health. With an annual Medicare wellness visit, you get a personalized prevention plan focused on your good health. Visit dschd.org or call 806-364-7512.
Needing extra income? Looking for a full-time job with advancement opportunities? McDonald's in Hereford is hiring full-time and part-time people who are energetic and customer-focused. At McDonald's, you will be able to work flexible hours, whether it's 3 hours or 8 hours per day. Benefits include a free meal when you're working and a 30% discount when you're off-duty. Earn a vacation benefit and $10 an hour and above with experience. To apply, just text TX162 to 38000.
First Financial Bank wonders, how does your credit card treat you?
Well, their bill is always on time. Does that count?
You should visit First Financial. We have a variety of credit card options. Once approved, you'll get rewards just for using them.
Rewards?
Yes, like cash back, gift cards, travel, and more.
I could get used to treatment like that.
First Financial Bank, you first. The creditor and issuer of these cards is Elan Financial Services. See FFIN.com for details. Cash back redeemable as a cash deposit to your First Financial checking or savings account or as a statement credit.
Hereford ISD. We are committed to children and dedicated to excellence. Hereford ISD encompasses over 900 square miles. We educate approximately 4,000 students each year and employ approximately 650 employees. Hereford ISD buses over 700 students to and from school each day. We provide 14 bus routes and drive over 1,100 miles per day. We choose to make a difference in the lives of all of our children. Go Herd!
No. Just lay up a free throw and a three-pointer in 30 seconds.
All right, back here at Whiteface Gym. It's halftime, 32-27. Whiteface's lead by seven in a very important basketball game, Coach.
Yep, absolutely it is. It's, you know, I the Whitefaces for 8 fouls in that first half compared to, oh, my gosh, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
Wow.
none of which the Perryton coach believed occurred. He is quite animated, but
no.
it has been both teams playing just like they know the seriousness of what this ball game is.
The Whiteface is don't really have any foul trouble of any consequence. Lopez with two and Brandon Gonzalez with two. We've been fortunate in that regard, but Perryton certainly here to play. I mean, they're playing hard.
Yeah, I mean, they understand how important this is to them, and knowing that they've got Kenyon next, it is a huge game for Perryton, just like it is.
So we've had the halftime shooting contest.
Yeah, a shout out to the Whiteface Booster Club and all they're doing. I mean, this is a cool contest, and I'm telling you, they are everywhere.
Yep.
And they have been just busy with so many events and so many sports with our kids. And we certainly do appreciate those guys and gals and what they do and the commitment they've shown to our kids and kind of drawing attention to the sport. And they've gathered many sponsors, too.
Yep.
Every week.
Yeah.
It's been a different two or three sponsors too. So we appreciate it, you guys. Whiteface Booster Club and all those sponsors that have been sponsoring this free throw or this contest here at basketball games. But many, many other events as well.
Whiteface wrestlers had a good day today, and they've got, I believe Coach said, 10 of their 12 wrestlers.
Yeah.
In the semifinals tomorrow, so
yeah,
a chance to go to the state tournament if you're a winner in the semifinal. Here we go, we're shooting again. Now we've got professionals involved here. We have coaches and Nicole, who's an employee. She couldn't accept anything from the school. Well, both ladies. No.
Get it in there to stop.
Well, nope. In and out.
That was long.
Well, I'm not sure how much longer we've got to shoot here. Time is wasting.
No, yes, go, man.
But, well, they got close. That's all I can say.
They did.
They got close. All right, let's. What's the first half scoring total?
We have got. Let's see, Diego has a great second quarter. 9 points just in the second quarter.
Wow.
For Diego, Ty's got 6 points. 7 points for Zevin. Gonzalez, we've got. Hayden has got 3. 2 points for Brandon Gonzalez.
Okay, come down, Hayden.
Dayton DeLozier, Jake Fletcher. So scoring spread out in the white faces, which is a good thing when you're looking at the Perryton side, 6, 8, 10, 12.
Wow.
12 for Cervantes, and he leads the score.
Yeah, he's 6 out of 6 at the free throw line.
Mm-hmm.
They only have one senior on this Perryton team. That's Shigota. Shigota got in foul trouble. Early, he got 3 fouls and went out. I would assume he would come back and start the second half, but they may hold him out a while longer. I don't know. But he's the only senior on this Perryton. No, I beg your pardon. He and Rigdon is a senior. So 2 seniors on the Perryton squad. So I don't know. I guess we're going to shoot for the entire half here. Is that
maybe.
Adam, all right, Adam.
There you go.
Okay, now this is what we came for. Adam Pena.
No offense, Juan, but
is going to shoot
sure,
a layup, a free throw, and then a
right,
3-point
seconds.
Shot. That's, layup. Of course, three assuming he makes the layup.
Ready? Let's go.
All right, these, I think, the final shooters of the night. Adam
here
driving in, lays it off. Oh, he missed.
Oh.
He made it, okay.
There we go.
He's got one.
Get that in there.
And the free throw. Oh, not too good
here
there.
We go.
Oh, no. He's made the free throw. He's shooting the 3. Oh, no. In and out. Short. Come on, Adam. Don't choke at this point. No. Golly.
Good job.
No. He's out of time. Gosh, he had a couple go down deep, but they did not stay down. And so, Adam gets nothing. That's probably the way.
You'll have nothing in like it.
Yep. That's probably the way the Eagles game's going to go tomorrow.
Oh, man.
Anthony Gonzalez.
A Sunday, not tomorrow.
Come on down.
Good than that, we're going to do more. We're going to take a break, what we're going to do. We'll take a break back to the studio for 60 seconds, and we'll be right back.
The brightest star in the Lone Star State, Stevens 5-Star Car and Truck Center. One price selling makes it easy to buy. You get 5-star treatment, we treat you great. We're stars and great selection, the quality and value too.
At Jeff Smith Electric Cooperative, providing members like you with reliable, affordable electricity will always be our first priority. But there's another valuable resource you can count on us for, information. Information on how you have a voice in your cooperative, about how to save money on your electric bill, and even the latest on renewable energy options in our community. All provided by local advisors you can depend on as much as your energy. We are your not-for-profit Touchstone Energy Co-op, your source of power and information.
All right, back here courtside. It's halftime. The Whiteface is up by 7 over Perryton as the Rangers are back out shooting here, getting warmed up. The officials are back out. They put some more time on the clock, so I don't know if the Whitefaces will come on out or not. Let's take one more 60-second break, and we'll be right back.
Whatever your type of home, experience a new level of home comfort with the new Bryant Evolution system. When installed with the Evolution Connect control, this advanced system can communicate with both your indoor and outdoor units for increased comfort and efficiency. Ask your Bryant dealer about an Evolution heating and cooling system today.
Call Bob's Heating and Air at 364-1195, your local factory authorized Bryant dealer.
As the new year unfolds, new projects are born. If you are interested or have any questions regarding a consumer or commercial loan, First National Bank of Hereford can assist you. You will be working with Hereford's only locally owned bank. Applying is easy with our online consumer application, or visit any of our locations to apply for your personal or business needs. First National Bank of Hereford and Friona Banking Center. We have roots where others have branches. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
All righty, back here, second half about to get underway. Whiteface is up by 7. Again, they added time to the scoreboard, so I guess we're going to go ahead and let the guys warm up for a couple of minutes here if they wish. Whiteface is not warming up, only Kenyon and Brendlin shooting out here right now, but they will get going here in just a minute. I did get a chance to talk to Mr. Silva, and
yes,
he said it is just like offsetting fouls in a football game.
Really?
And you just play on.
Well,
but you do shoot. I mean, like, we shot the free throws. That had already occurred. And then they just erase each other, and you play like
happened.
I did not know that.
I didn't either.
But that's good. It's good to learn things every day because I forget a lot.
If I knew it, I forgot it, and that's likely.
Yep. All right. The officials are back out. The teams are out. And I think we're ready to play some basketball here at Whiteface Gym.
Cheerleaders are here in force.
Cheerleaders are they're everywhere in force. They are all the time.
They are.
Full bore.
So many things that they
have
got to go to and travel to. And I bet they love it when they get home games.
I bet they do, too. And I bet they're the wrestling tomorrow over at it's at WT. Isn't that where they're wrestling?
I've heard it's been run really well. And
I saw a picture today, and it looked like there was a big crowd there. I don't like the stands, at least the part of the stands I could see, were pretty full. Here at Whiteface Gym, Hereford and Perryton, again, the winner is, if it's Hereford, we're in the playoffs. That's not official, but that is official, I think. Because if we win, here's my thinking. If we win, and even let's say they somehow upset Kenyon, they would have lost to us both times.
Right.
So,
kind of like the deal with with the girls.
Yep.
You know, we ended up having to go fourth because Pampa, who's going as a third, they beat us both times. We ended up with the same records. But Pampa takes that third slot.
Yeah, our girls won 8 games. They swept Perryton. They swept Border. They swept, let's see, who else did we sweep? West Plains, and we swept whoever out, Dumas.
Mm-hmm.
But then we lost. We were swept by Canyon and Randall and Pampa, of all people. So there you go. Herford's ball, here we go. Final half here of the regular season home games for the Whitefaces. Herford with the ball. Kenyon's got it here on the right side. He goes to the baseline. He can't shoot. Back for a three from Gonzalez. He misses, gets the rebound up and in. Peyton Gonzalez missed, but got the rebound and scored. We lead by 9. Here comes Shigota and the Rangers. Rigdon on the outside. Down low. Shigota's open. Misses. And the ball belongs to the Whitefaces. Back the other way come the Whitefaces. Perryton coach wanted a foul call there and didn't get it called. So the Whitefaces have a 9-point lead in the ball. Here goes Duque underneath. He is fouled. And the foul will be, I believe, on Hernandez. 7:12 left, third quarter. Whiteface ball with a 9-point lead. It'll be Kenyon to put it in play. They bring Hernandez and 3 fouls out of the ball game.
Four fouls.
He comes out of the ball game. He didn't start, but he's played as much as anyone. Inbounds to Hayden. Hayden in the lane, can't shoot. Out to Zevin. Zevin back in the corner to Duque. Duque around the perimeter. Gets banged around. Spins and shoots and misses. And the rebound belongs to the Rangers. Here comes Rigdon, 3-on-2, off in the corner. 3-point shot, rebound! No good, nope.
Rebound
to Perryton, then they throw it back in the corner and
rebound
throw it away.
No!
I don't know, the ball bounced a couple of times. We just kind of stood there.
Yep.
And Perryton wound up with the ball. But Hereford gets it back. 6:46 left, third period, we lead by 9. Across midcourt, now comes Duque. Right side pass goes to Hayden. Out front to Zevin. Left side now to Todd. 6:35 left, third period. Duque directing traffic. Trying to get somebody out here to help him now. Gets it to Hayden. Hayden starts in to Zevin on the baseline. Loses the ball. Gets it back. Throws it cross court to Duque. Duque in the lane. Back out to Hayden for 3. It's up. It's good. 37-25. Hayden Gonzalez with a 3. Here comes Cervantes all the way. Cervantes charges into Duque. Hereford gets it back. Up by a dozen. Whitefaces have the basketball. That's 2 fouls on Cervantes. 6:08 to play. Third quarter. Tie up the court. Across the midcourt line. On his right, out here is Kenyon. Need to get Kenyon a couple of good looks and get him hit some buckets here. Inside, Hereford loses the ball, and back it goes the other way. Shigota in the forecourt for the Rangers. Stops his dribble, gives it off to Cervantes. 5:42 left, third period. Pull-up jumper by Cervantes is good. 37-27. Hereford by 10. Tie back the other way. Ahead quickly now to Hayden. Hayden's going to pull it out and set it up. Off to Zevin. 5:25 left, third period. Off to Duque, the Perryton coach at midcourt here, just screaming at the official. Here is Ty in the corner. He goes down the baseline. He gets fouled, and it'll be the third foul against the Rangers. Foul is on Rigdon. 5:13 left, third period. 10-point Whiteface lead. Kenyon to put it in play. Inbounds to Fletcher. Fletcher in the corner, outside to Duque, around to the low post, now to Fletcher. Fletcher loses the ball. It's out of bounds off of Perryton.
Well, Fletcher collapsed on Fletcher.
Yeah, he instead of going up, I think he got hit across the face, honestly, and all of that. He's kind of rubbing on his nose here. Here's the inbounds ball to Hayden. Shigota with 3 fouls has him. Left side pass goes to Duque. Duque now dribbles inside. Can't go there, so he just pulls it out. Gives it back to Fletcher. Off to Hayden it comes. Hayden now on the right side. Can't get inside. Gives it back to Fletcher at the top of the circle. Fletcher off to Duque. Duque inside to Zevin. Zevin turns and misses, follows and scores. 39-37. Hereford by a dozen again. 4:35 left, third period. Rigdon off in the corner. They shoot the three. It's no good. Rebound off to Perryton. Perryton fires it down low inside.
Shigoda
puts it up. He misses. Rebound. Oh, my goodness. Off of Perryton, out of bounds. The Perryton coach is real close to tee time. Perryton subs in. 4:20 left, third period. Hereford up by 12. The Perryton coach is one more word away from getting teed up. 4:20 left, and he is really, really going.
Yeah, it'll happen for two.
Yep.
Duque with the ball. Tarango on him at midcourt. Ties, foul by Tarango.
Perryton coach upset again.
I think Tarango just steps in there. There's not much you can, not much way you can't call it. Four fouls against Perryton here. We're not to the halfway. Oh, my goodness. Tarango pushes off again. Gets away with it in the forecourt now. Outside to Kenyon. He dumps it off to Haven. He pulls up a 10-footer. It is no good. Up and in by Zevin. And a foul on, nope. Oh, foul on Zevin. 3:59 left, third period. I believe we missed that one. Shigoda will inbound it for the Rangers. 12-point lead for the Whitefaces. 3:57 left, third quarter. Rigdon inside to Shigoda. Shigoda back to Cervantes in the corner. Tarango back to Cervantes. 3:45 left in the period. Cervantes in the lane, dumps it out. Shigoda cross court. Three-point shot up and in and out. Rebound. Shigoda. Shigoda's foul, and DeLozier draws the foul. It'll be two free throws for Shigoda. 3:33 left, third quarter. 12-point lead for the Whitefaces. Two free throws for Tad Shigoda, one of the two seniors on the floor for the Rangers. Shoots the first. It is good. 39-28. Perryton coach talking constantly to the officials. Second chance here. Shigoda puts it up, makes them both. 10-point lead, timeout Perryton. 3:33 left, third quarter. We're back in 30 seconds.
Did you know that every internet-connected device poses a risk to your home network? Protect IQ from WTRT and WT Services provides an extra layer of protection by blocking viruses, malware, and malicious attacks. It even works on devices such as smart thermostats and video doorbells. Protect your home today by adding Protect IQ to your internet service plan. Don't have the WT Smart Home app? Download it in app stores today.
Whiteface is up by 10. Whiteface cheerleaders doing those handstands that scare me to death, but they seem to know what they're doing, so everybody's back on the floor safely. 39-29, Hereford leads, has the ball. We're in the final 3 minutes plus of the third quarter. The Rangers have four fouls in the quarter. The Whitefaces two. And the Whitefaces will inbound the ball when the timeout ends. It's Kenyon, Ty, Dayton, Hayden, and Zevin are the five on the floor for the Whitefaces. 3:33 left in the quarter. Inbounds to Duque. He gives it off to Kenyon. Kenyon up near midcourt. They're running a little zone trap here at midcourt. Kenyon throws it to the inside. Back out front now to Ty. Ty dumps it off. On the right side, we've got a whistle away from the ball. What was the call? I guess the three-second call. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Okay. 10-point ball game. Rigdon ahead to Shigoda. He passes it off to Cervantes in the corner. They shoot the three and make it. Tarango makes it 39-32. Big bucket there for the Rangers. Hereford against the zone press. Duque in the forecourt. Cross midcourt. He gets knocked out of bounds by Tarango. That's five on the Rangers. Hereford's ball with 2:55 left. I mean, the fouls are just so obvious that you could not call them. 2:56 left, third period. Kenyon to inbound. It does so to Ty. Tarango picks him up. Ty at midcourt now against the double team. Bounces it ahead to Kenyon. Kenyon gets it to Gonzalez, and we lose it. Now it's a two-on-one, and Cervantes scores, and it's a five-point game, a three and then a steal, and a call against the White Faces.
What?
No, timeout call. I beg your pardon. Timeout call. 2:36 left, third quarter. White Faces up by five. We're back in 30 seconds.
Happy State Bank proudly offers a special service for our customers. Save the cents, a simple way to build your savings. When you use your debit card, we'll round up to the nearest dollar and you start saving. It's that simple. Stop by a Happy State Bank branch today and ask about our Save the Cents program. Visit happybank.com for more details. Happy State Bank, a division of Centennial Bank. Member FDIC. Certain transaction fees, replacement fees, limitations, requirements may apply. Must have a Happy State Bank personal checking account, personal savings account, and debit card to enroll. Refer to product terms and conditions to see bank for details.
All right, the White Faces went up by 12. Perryton made a couple of free throws, then made a three, and the White Faces turned the ball over, and they made a two, and it's a five-point game. And here comes Ty up the floor, 2:28 left, third period. Picked up on the outside now by Samples. Left side pass, now top of the circle to Hayden. Down low to Fletch, back in the corner. Kenyon for three, it is no good. Rebound tipped away. Kenyon gets it back. Off to Hayden. He goes to the bucket. Can't shoot. Back it comes to the outside to Kenyon. Top of the circle now. Hayden down low. Fletch up and in. 41-34. Great pass by Hayden there. Fletcher with the bucket. 2 minutes left. Here's Rigdon. 2 minutes left, third period. Rigdon off the glass and in. Again, it's back to five. Minute 53 left, third period. They're back in the zone press. Duque's got it in the forecourt. Throws it off to Zevon. Zevon can't shoot. Back inside Duque. Back to Zevon. Cross court to Hayden. Hayden to the bucket. Puts it up. It's no good. Rebound off to Fletcher. Fletcher outside to Kenyon. Kenyon to Zevon. Zevon down on the baseline to Hayden. Hayden travels. 5-point lead, and the White Faces turn it over on the travel with 1:30 left in the third quarter. Well, we just can't pull away. Give Perryton credit. Battling here. Rigdon here near midcourt. To his right. 1:22 left in the third quarter. 5-point Hereford lead, but the Rangers with the ball. There's a foul on Gonzalez. Hayden, his the White Faces third. Mm-hmm. Brandon's coming in. That's the first or second on Hayden. So he checks out of the ball game with his team up by five and a minute 16 left in the third quarter. Inbounds from Cervantes. He brings it into Rigdon. Brandon Gonzalez has him. Rigdon heads to the bucket. Throws it cross court. Ball's tipped out of bounds by Hereford.
Boy, they just work to get those threes, don't
they? They want to shoot the threes. Here's Lopez in now, and the White Faces bring Fletcher out. So we're going little here for the last 1:07 of the third quarter. Inbounds now to Cervantes. Cervantes drives inside in traffic. Thank you. He's going to shoot. Oh, man. Two free throws for Cervantes. 1:03 left in the quarter. That's the foul zone.
Loftus.
Foul was on, Loftus. Cervantes shoots. And his perfect night at the line continues. 41-37. He has kept them in the ball game. And he's got a chance to make it a three-point game. What was a 12-point lead just a moment ago? A minute three left, third quarter. He makes them both. 1:03 remaining, third period. 41-39. White Faces by two, although the scoreboard shows three. Maybe it's 41-38. Here we go against the zone press. Lopez has got it in traffic. Down the right corner now to Kenyon. Kenyon steps back. Back inside to Zevon. Cross court now to Duque. Ty in the corner. 3-point shot for Zevon's no good. Rebound off to, wow. Duque just got hammered by Blackshear.
Here is Cervantes all the way down. He scored 41-40. Cervantes taking over the game for Perryton. Tied to Lopez. Lopez to Brandon. Brandon in the corner, drives down the baseline. Gives it to Loftus, back to Duque. 18 seconds left in the quarter. Duque off to Brandon. Brandon shoots and in and out. Oh, rebound Perryton. 11 seconds left. They've got a chance to take the lead here, down 41-40. It's Cervantes. He makes it, 42-41. Perryton will lead going into the fourth quarter as the Rangers have taken over behind the junior, Julian Cervantes. And it's 8 minutes to play with the Rangers up by one, back in 60 seconds.
When life's unexpected moments happen, you can rest easy knowing Prairie Insurance is on your side. Prairie Insurance will listen to you and help tailor a policy to meet your needs. They offer multiple insurance products, including home, auto, business, and farm insurance, with the knowledge to make sure you're covered. Give them a call at 363-6489 or stop by their office at 213 West Park Avenue. When you're ready to have peace of mind regarding the things that matter most, call Prairie Insurance at 363-6489 or stop by 213 West Park Avenue and they'll make sure you're covered.
One of the most difficult things we experience in life is losing a loved one. So when that time comes, please make sure you place your loved one in the hands of people that truly care about your family and the service that your family deserves when experiencing loss. There is nothing more important at that time, so allow Mendez and Mullins Family Funeral Home to take care of those needs with the utmost respect for you and your family. Hereford's only family-owned and operated funeral home. Our family serving your family.
Julian Cervantes with 10 points in that quarter has 22 for the ball game, 22 of the 42. Perryton has the ball and a one-point lead. Hereford led by 12 in that quarter before the Rangers just came roaring back. Inbounds now, and it's Cervantes with the ball. We just can't stop him. He goes in the corner, gives it away to Rigdon. Rigdon with Loftus on him, throws it away, but saved by Shigoda. Shigoda back out to Cervantes. We've got a blocking foul on... Wow, Duque upset. He got bowled into by Cervantes, but the foul goes against Ty. It's his second. And it's with 7:42 left. The Rangers have the ball and a one-point lead. Cervantes inside, off the glass. It's good. 44-41. Cervantes with 24. The Whitefaces trail by three. 7:29 to play. Duque on the outside. Working to his left now. Cervantes on him. He goes to the bucket. He is fouled. He'll shoot two. 7:17 left. And I'll tell you, Ty has away from the ball a couple of times. They are just pushing and shoving on him every time. Two free throws for Ty. We trail by three, 7:17 to play. The Rangers trying to get up off the deck. They have gotten up off the deck and steal a win here against the Whitefaces. Ty now going to shoot the first and make it 44-42. We had a long dry spell there. I didn't mark it, but again, we got outscored by 15 points over about a three-minute time. Ty can make it a one-point ball game as he shoots, makes them both. 44-43, full court pressure. Inbounds to Shigoda. Shigoda gets it to Rigdon. Rigdon trapped here. Back to Shigoda. Ahead now to Cervantes. In the corner, they shoot the three. It is no good. Rebound off to Hayden. Hayden to Ty. Ty in the backcourt. Up the floor, getting pushed and shoved. Gets the ball ahead. Outside now, in the corner. Three-point shot for Zevin is good. It's 46-44 Hereford. Timeout Whitefaces with 6:51 left. Big three-pointer by Zevin. Back in 30 seconds.
Heard athletes work tirelessly on the fundamentals of their particular sport while learning to work in a team concept. It's not much different at Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union. Our employees have a dedication to serve our members daily with the fundamentals of good business.
Being friendly and helping give you peace of mind and knowing that when you need banking assistance, you can get it from our knowledgeable staff. Hereford Texas Federal Credit Union, member NCUA, working as a team since 1936 with our members. Go Herd.
Well, 46-44 Hereford. Nothing easy about this.
Nothing easy at all, I'm telling you. And looking at this too, 10 for 10 is Perryton from the free throw line.
Wow.
White Faces are 15 of 17.
Wow.
That's just great.
Well, Cervantes is what? He's 8 out of 8 at the line, something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, he is indeed.
He's got 24 of their 46 points. And we just can't, I mean, he just goes to the bucket and we can't stop him. That's been the what's occurred lately. Let's see what happens here. Full court pressure now. Inbounding the ball is Chagota. He brings it into Cervantes. Cervantes starts up the floor and loses the ball. Taken away by the White Faces. All the way now. The White Faces bring it down, whip it outside. Gonna set it up. 6:40 to play. Diego with the ball out front now here to Hayden. Hayden around the right side. Off it goes to Zevin. White Faces again going without the big here. Ball back to Kenyon. Kenyon passes it off on the left side to Zevin. 6:20 to play. Good defense here by the Rangers. Diego goes down the line. Lane misses the shot. And back the other way we go. Rigdon. There's the steal by the White Faces, but we lost it out of bounds. Coach Loftus wanted to walk a moment ago, but he didn't get it. I think he's correct, but inbounds Cervantes now. Diego has him. Gets it ahead the forecourt. They throw it to Segoda. He won't shoot, but Cervantes shoots a three and misses, and the rebound belongs to the White Faces, and the foul belongs to...
Oh, my.
Five in red. That is Blackshear. It's 1-1 at the other end with 5:53 left. Well, I didn't see how it could be. There were two fives, he and Hayden, and I didn't see how it could not go against them. But the first call looked like it was against the White Faces.
Five red.
That is four fouls on Blackshear. 5:53 left. Hayden with the 1-1. It is no good. Rebound off to Zevin. Great save. White Faces have it. In the corner now. Back to Duque. Back it comes to Hayden. Back to Duque. Ty has it knocked away but gets it back. Now he penetrates. Bluffs the shot. Gives it back to Kenyon. 5:36 left. Off to Diego. He puts it up in the lane. The shot's blocked. 5:30 left. Cervantes with the block there. Back the other way comes Rigdon. Rigdon in the lane, dumps it down low, ball lost. And a whistle and a timeout by Perryton. With 5:18 left, Hereford leads by two. We're back in 30 seconds.
When the unthinkable happens, good neighbors show up. For 100 years, State Farm has been among the first to arrive with the latest technology and tools to help you recover faster. State Farm has been there before, and they'll be there again and again. Stop by and see your local State Farm insurance agent, Matt Silva, at 801 Main Street in Hereford. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Two-point lead for the White Faces. Perryton with the ball in the forecourt.
Oh, my.
What a night. What a game. Five fouls against Hereford, seven fouls against Perryton. Again, Cervantes has been the man for the Rangers. I don't know if we can stop him, but if we can, that'd go a long way toward getting the win. But we're a long way from a win with 5:18 to play. They have not fouled since the little outburst.
Mm-hmm. It changed
mid-court.
It, didn't it?
Yep,
it
did.
Changed things.
Inbounds, it comes to Chagota. He's on the baseline. He spins. He wants to shoot. He does, and he misses. And the rebound. They're going to call a foul on Zevin. Zevin Gonzalez with 5:12 to play. Gets the sixth foul against the White Faces.
Perryton gets the ball back underneath their bucket, down by two. Rigdon inbounds it to Tarango. Tarango with Brandon on him. He loses the ball. The Whiteface is out. And here is Zevon down the floor. He passes outside to Kenyon. 5 minutes left. 2-point lead in the ball for the Whiteface. Zevon down the baseline. Gets it to Ty. He lays it up and in. What a shot by Duque. 48-44. Hereford by four. 4:49 left. Cervantes back the other way. All the way. All the way. Lays it in. 48-46. Cervantes took it coast to coast. It's a 2-point game. Brandon in the forecourt. Ty in the corner. Out front to Kenyon. 4:30 to play. Kenyon double team gets it back to Ty. Ty down on the baseline. Kicks it out. Ball's kicked away. It's Hereford's ball. 48-46. Hereford up by two with the ball. 4:22 to play. Perryton fighting for their playoff life. Trails the Whitefaces by two. Inbounds to Kenyon. Rigdon has him. Kenyon at midcourt. Throws it ahead to Ty. Ty back out front to Kenyon. Inside Zevon. Off to Brandon. Brandon's fouled. He'll shoot two. Well, we had two players. Zevon could have laid it in there. I think he passed to Brandon. And Brandon gets his back jumped on as he tries to shoot. 4:09 left. 48-46. 2-point Hereford lead. And that is Blackshear, who's fouled out of the ball game for Perryton. He'll be replaced by Tarango. 4:09 left in the ball game. We've got four on him here. I don't know. I think they're changing that. I think it is four fouls on him. Two free throws here. Up by two. The Whitefaces lead. Brandon Gonzalez is the shooter. Misses the first. Oh, my goodness. Still a two-point game. 4:09 left. Whitefaces with a two-point advantage. Perryton about to get the ball back after Brandon shoots this free throw. He makes one of the two. Three-point lead, full court pressure. One-and-one situation for Perryton if the Whitefaces foul. Here's Rigdon in the forecourt, in the corner to Cervantes. Off the glass and in. 49-48, it's a one-point game. 3:55 left. Duque ahead to Kenyon. Off to Hayden. Hayden gives it out to Duque inside now. The Whitefaces throw it down on the baseline. Can't shoot. Now bring it back outside to Hayden. 3:38 left. Hayden. Duque for three. It is no good. Perryton a chance to take the lead with 3:30 to play. Cervantes down the floor. Cervantes. Fouled by Hayden. Wow. He'll shoot one and one. 3:25 left. He can give his club the lead. 49-48 Hereford. Seven fouls against the Whitefaces. As back into the ballgame for Perryton comes Samples. Cervantes, the last man you want at the line if you're the Whitefaces. But he's going to handle the ball. We're going to have to stop him. He makes it 49-all. 3:25 to play. The Rangers can take the lead. Again, the officials trying to settle everybody down underneath. 49-49. Up it goes, and he makes them both. 50-49. Kenyon with the ball. Whitefaces trail by one. Kenyon at midcourt. Back to Duque. Duque through the double team. Back to Kenyon. 3:16 left. On the high post, now back to Brandon. Brandon around the perimeter. Gets it back to Hayden. Right side to Kenyon. Kenyon dribbles to his left, takes a three, misses. Rebound off to Perryton. Perryton in the backcourt, trapped. Gets the ball up the floor to Rigdon. Rigdon, Perryton up by one. Rigdon fouled by Brandon. He'll shoot one and one. Eight fouls against the Whitefaces. 2:51 left to play. Whitefaces down by one and Rigdon can widen the gap. 12-point lead in the third quarter for the Whitefaces evaporated, and now we find ourselves trailing 50-49. Rigdon shooting the 1-1. First one goes up. It is no good. Rebound off to the Whitefaces. Brandon's got it at midcourt. Brandon ahead now to Hayden. Hayden to Kenyon. Off to Duque. 2:40 to play. Duque with Cervantes on him. Outside now, the Whitefaces trying to get the offense set up, trailing by one. On the baseline, Hayden's got it. 2:29 left. Inside Zevin. Pull-up jumper is good. 51-50. Hereford leads. Zevin with a big bucket. 2:20 to play. Here comes Cervantes. Ahead now to Rigdon. Down low. Inside a charge. Duque draws the charge on Sappo. Herford's ball. 2:15 left. A one-point lead and the ball for the Whitefaces. Perryton coach again up on the officials. Here comes Ty against the zone press. He gives it up, takes it now up near midcourt. Across midcourt. Ahead now to inside. Now they foul Kenyon. The foul is on Samples. It'll be a 1-1 for Kenyon. We lead 51-50 with 2:02 to play. 2:02 left. Kenyon to the line. Ten fouls against the Rangers with 2:02 left. Kenyon makes the first, 52-50. Brandon in here for the Whitefaces. Who's coming out? Fletcher out. 2:02 left. 52-50 Hereford. Second chance now for Kenyon. He steps to the line, dribbles it once, puts it up. Made them both. 53-50. Two clutch free throws there. In the backcourt, it's Shaboda. Ahead to Rigdon. Rigdon shoots a long three that's nowhere near the mark. And the rebound belongs to, well, it's a jump ball. It'll be Perryton's ball. Cervantes and Duque wound up tying it up. Fletcher comes in for the Whitefaces. 1:51 left. A three-point lead for Hereford. We're trying to play defense and offense here. It'll be Cervantes to inbound it. 53-50 Hereford. Into Shigoda. Shigoda throws it back to Cervantes. Shoots a long three and misses. Rebound Fletcher. Fletcher to Duque. 1:41 left. Duque in the forecourt to Kenyon. Kenyon gets knocked down. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Kenyon gets fouled and no call. Now the officials, I think, are going to converse. I think that this call may go the other way. The ball was off of Kenyon out of bounds. But Kenyon got hacked on the arm by Shigoda.
And trying the officials, to consensus,
yep, 1:35 left. Hereford up by three. This is a huge discussion here. Still not decided. Officials conversing. They're not going to change it. Wow. Wow. Well, that's a tough one there. Perryton's ball. Timeout Perryton. Three-point Hereford lead. We're back in a minute 35.
Since 1901, the Hereford brand has been keeping readers informed and entertained with all things Hereford. A weekly historical column, detailed recaps of city and county government meetings, and photos of your favorite Herd athlete or youngster fishing in the pond. Things have changed some since the early days, like being able to get the paper sent straight to your email. But some things have stayed the same, like providing local content you need to read. The Hereford brand, back in downtown Hereford, across from the courthouse.
Oh, there's nothing like the sound of a new baby calf or the smell of fresh rain on a cotton crop. My friends at Capital Farm Credit share this excitement with agricultural and livestock producers. We want to be your lending partner. Whether you require operating funds for next year's crop or need to buy hay for your cattle, we have a loan that's right for you. Let us finance your operation. CapitalFarmCredit.com.
Start here, AC. Go anywhere. After serving my country in the military and a bout with colon cancer, I got a new start right here at Amarillo College. Great programs, great faculty. Start here, go anywhere.
Trust your future to a college that cares.
Start here, AC.
Go anywhere.
Back at Whiteface Gym, Whiteface has stole the inbounds pass, then got fouled. So it'll be Zevon shooting two free throws. We lead 53-50. 1 minute, 30 seconds left in the ball game. Zevon makes the first. Boy, he's had a great final home game here tonight, has Zevon Gonzalez. Puts Hereford up by four, a minute 30, though a long time to go. Second chance here to make it a 5-point game. And he doesn't. Misses, and the rebound belongs to Rigdon as he comes up the floor. Rigdon ahead now to Shigoda. Shigoda back to Rigdon. 120 left. Rigdon forces and misses the shot. Rebound loose. And it's finally controlled by Perryton and a foul on Kenyon. 114 left. 4-point ball game and the foul on Kenyon.
You're good.
The shooter will be Blackshear. He'll shoot 1-1. That's 9 fouls against Hereford. So 10 fouls. Both teams with 2 shot fouls. So now free throws up. It's no good. Rebound off to Zevon. Whiteface's lead by 4. Have the ball with 1:10 to play. Kenyon across midcourt. Off to Zevon. Back to Kenyon. 104 left. Kenyon taken away by Chigoda. Ahead to Cervantes. He makes it a 2-point game. 57 seconds left. Whiteface's lead 54-52. Whiteface is going to have to take a timeout. They do. Timeout Hereford with 47 seconds left and a 2-point Hereford lead. We'll keep it here this time. My gosh, we had them and let them get away, Coach.
Yeah, and you better believe Cervantes is going to be the man to take it to the bucket. Yep. He's got 4 fouls. 32
of the 52 points for him. I cannot believe what a night he has had. And, I mean, this game would have been over a long time ago, but
yes.
For Cervantes.
Yep, you're exactly right.
Anytime you score, a guard scores 32 of the 52, that's a bunch of points. We have the ball, we have a 2-point lead, and we have 47 seconds left to play here at Whiteface Gym. Timeout taken there by the Whitefaces. Now they're going to break the huddle. Come back out. I don't know what the timeout situation is here. How many either teams got left? Each team has one timeout left, says Mr. Silva. So Hereford's ball at midcourt. We've got Brandon out there now. The Whitefaces have the small team, if you will. Zevon will inbound it. Any fouls, a 2-shot foul. Inbounds, he comes to Hayden. Hayden back to Brandon. Brandon ahead to Ty. Ty is fouled by Shigoda. With 42 seconds left, Duque will shoot 2 free throws. His team leading by 2. Fourth foul on Shigoda. Again, Fletcher will go in after the first free throw. 42 seconds left to play. Whiteface is up 54-52. First free throw by Duque goes up. And it goes in and out. Still a 2-point game. We shot free throws well all night, but we've missed a couple down the stretch here. And now Ty gets one more chance to make it a 3-point lead with 42 seconds to play. Crowd on their feet on both sides. Ty dribbles it twice, 3 times. Bends at the knees. Puts it up, and it is good. 53-52. Full court pressure. Inbounds to Shigoda. Back to Cervantes. Cervantes in the backcourt. Ahead to Shigoda. Shigoda across midcourt. In the corner, they shoot the 3. It is good. We're tied at 55 with 31 seconds left. Rigdon made the 3. Duque to Kenyon. A travel called on Kenyon in the backcourt. 23 seconds left, tied at 55, and Perryton gets the ball. What a call. 55 seconds to play. The White Faces turn it over, and Perryton has a chance to take the lead. I won't say what I'm going to say. Official over to talk to the Whiteface coaches, but I mean, nothing's going to change.
Yeah, Whitefaces need to figure out what we want to do.
We've got to get about our business here. 55 seconds, 55-55, a tie game. And I'll just say this, it is a strange time for trouble. It is Perryton's ball. We are tied at 55. And they've got a chance to win the game right here.
Yeah, you got to figure they're cooking something up for Cervantes for sure.
Oh, sure.
I mean,
sure.
Coaches, they love shooting threes, but
golly
still.
Golly bum. 55 all, that's the score. The Whitefaces and Perryton. We've had the lead. Perryton has come back. I should say Cervantes has come back. And then Rigdon hit that three a moment ago that tied the game. Again, two-shot foul. If we foul, they'll go to the line for two. Shigota to put it in play for Perryton. Inbounds to Rigdon. Rigdon has Zevon on him. Out at midcourt, he passes off to Tarango. 15 seconds to play. Back to Shigota. 55 all, Rigdon. 9 seconds left. Rigdon to Shigota. Shigota misses the shot. The rebound comes to no one. Finally, Hereford. Down to 8 tenths. We're in overtime. We call timeout. Hereford got a timeout. I don't know how much time they're going to put back on the clock. Hereford called a timeout. We have the ball at midcourt. And let's see. 1.2 seconds left to play. Tied at 55. The Whitefaces will have a chance to get a shot off. With 1.2 seconds left, the ball at midcourt. My goodness. Whitefaces talking to our right. Perryton to our left. Again, Perryton obviously cannot afford to foul. Had something happen over in the stands across the way.
Yes, we were hauling it down the floor, and we hit two or three people. One of them was a little child. And also a woman on the front row, and
Sarah's over to look at them.
Oh, that little baby! He went flying.
Wow. Well, 1.23 seconds left in the ball game. We're tied at 55. Perryton had a chance to win it.
Mm-hmm. Good job taking care of your defensive business, Whitefaces.
It was a great job. Fletcher really offered. Shigota's shot. The Whitefaces can win this thing here in regulation, but we've got to inbound it. We've got to inbound it and shoot here in 1.23 seconds. So let's see what we do with it. It's going to be inbounded by Hayden. Once it's touched, the clock starts. Inbounds, it comes to Butter from midcourt. He shoots. Oh, just off at the buzzer. We're in overtime, tied at 55. 5 minute overtime when we come back in 1 minute.
Your business, farm and ranch, or home is unique, and success depends in part on a cost-effective and convenient supply of quality fuel. When you trust your fueling needs to Gooden Fuels, it's one less detail for you to manage. Commercial fuel in bulk in below ground or above ground tanks. Serving the Western Panhandle with gasoline, diesel, and propane. Gooden Fuels in Hereford, 364-3366.
For generations, First Bank Southwest has been there to help the working hands that have shaped this great land. Chances are we helped your father, and even his father. We understand for some, a handshake is a stronger bond than a piece of paper. And even though times can be tough, folks around here are tougher. And that's why we're as proud of our Panhandle roots as you are. First Bank Southwest, moving your generation in the right direction. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Well, here's what we got. We've got a game tied at 55 going to overtime. First overtime game we've had in the district campaign. They'll jump at midcourt. Fletcher against Shigoda. We'll play 4 minutes. I said five earlier. 4 minutes. If someone's ahead, it's over. If they're not, we play four more. Whiteface is going to the bucket to our right. Perryton the other way, obviously. Fletcher tips it, and it's controlled by Cervantes. And he goes straight to the bucket and misses a bad shot. And the rebound bombs to Zeta. Well, Cervantes has had a great night, but he's taken a couple of shots lately that have not been well advised. That was one of them. Here's Duque with Blackshear on him. Passes off to Hayden. Inside Fletcher. Off the glass. No good. Out of bounds off Earth. Fletcher got it down low. Banked it too hard. We're still tied at 55 with 3:35 left in the overtime. Inbounds it goes now in the backcourt to Rigdon. Ahead to Shigoda. He goes in the lane, lays it up, misses. Fletcher gets the rebound. Back the other way come the White Faces. Across midcourt. It's Kenyon with the ball. Kenyon off to Duque. Duque inside, back in the corner. Kenyon for three. It's no good. Rebound off to Perryton. Ball stolen by Hayden. Shot up by Zevon. Hereford leads 57-55. The Gonzalez brothers combining for the block, the steal, and the bucket. Inbounds knocked out of bounds by Hereford. 2:59 left. Hereford up 57-55 in overtime here at Whiteface Gym. Shigoda Cervantes down the floor in the corner. They shoot the three. It's no good. Rebound off to Hayden. Hayden to Zevon, Zevon to Duque. 2:49 left in overtime. Hereford has a two-point lead in the ball. Duque across midcourt. Double team comes around the right. Dribbles down the lane in the corner. Zevon for three. It is no good, but Fletcher gets the rebound. Up, it's no good, but he's fouled. Shigoda has fouled out of the ball game. 2:32 left. Fletcher will shoot two. Hereford leading 57-55. 2:32 left in the overtime. 57-55, Hereford. Fletcher stepping to the line now. His first trip to the line tonight. Five fouls on Shigoda. He comes out now as he's replaced by Alvarez. 57-55, Hereford. Shigoda down to shake hands with coach. 2:32 left in overtime. Fletcher with the first of two. Makes it 58-55. White faces by three. 2:32 remaining in OT. Whiteface Gym, a rocking place here tonight. Fletcher can make it a four-point game, and he does not. Rebound off to Perryton. We wind up with a jump ball, and it'll be Hereford's ball. 2:30 left in the overtime. The Whitefaces get it back, leading by three with 2:30 to play. Perryton coach passed midcourt here. Inbounds from Kenyon. It comes to Fletcher. Up he puts it, and it is no good. Rebound off to Perryton. In the backcourt now. Ahead to Alvarez. Alvarez knocked away by Duque. The ball is a travel on Perryton. Travel on Hereford, I beg your pardon. Perryton is fortunate to get that back. And the Perryton coach, again, just going berserk. 58-55, Hereford, 2:17 to play. Perryton inbounds the ball. And it comes from Rigdon into Hernandez. Hernandez gets it off now to Tarango. Tarango stops his dribble, passes outside to Rigdon. 2:05 left in overtime. Hereford by three. Rigdon in the lane, shoots and scores. 58-57, a one-point lead. Duque near midcourt now gets the pressure. Fires it ahead. Get it to Hayden. Back out to Duque. 1:47 left. Zevon. Baseline now to Kenyon. Off to Zevon. Wow, almost threw it away. Kenyon for three. It's good. 61-57. His first three of the night. 1:34 left in overtime. A whistle and a foul called in the backcourt on Duque. 1:31 left to play. Hereford up by four. Perryton will shoot two at the other end.
Well, that is three on tie. The shooter is Hernandez. 1:31 left, 61-57. Two free throws now. Everybody's in the two free throw situation. The first of the two now by Hernandez is no good. Still 61-57, Hereford. He can make it a three-point game as he shoots here. Whiteface is up by four, 1:31 left in OT. Hernandez with a second chance. Up it goes, and he missed it. Rebound off, out of bounds off Hereford. It'll be Perryton's ball. 1:30 left. Perryton gets the ball back after two free throw misses. 61-57 Whitefaces. Thought we were going to get the ball back.
There. Yep.
Inbounds now. They get it to Cervantes. Cervantes out to Rigdon. They're looking for the three. Rigdon, though, takes it in the lane, shoots, misses. Rebound to Gonzalez. Gonzalez to Duque. Duque now to Zevin, ahead to Hayden. 1:10 to play. Back to Zevin. Baseline jumper. 63-57. Minute five left. Whitefaces by six. Cervantes all the way. Inside. Shoots. Misses. Rebound. Out of bounds off of Perryton. 56 seconds left. A six-point lead in the ball. The Whitefaces have it. Timeout call by Perryton. Hereford leading by six. We're back in 30 seconds.
Deaf Smith County Hospital District helps our community senior citizens get the most out of life. Our Medicare Wellness Center provides free annual wellness visits for Medicare enrollees. Our team works with you to get up to date on screenings, immunizations, and other preventative care. Together, we review your medical history, assess your risk factors for illness, and discuss ways to reduce risks and promote health. With an annual Medicare wellness visit, you get a personalized prevention plan focused on your good health. Visit dschd.org or call 806-364-7512.
63-57 in overtime here at Whiteface Gym. The Whitefaces, that length of 47 seconds away, I should say, away from their sixth district win and a virtual clinching of the fourth place finish. Inbounding the ball to the Whitefaces is Zevin Gonzalez.
He's had a good overtime here, 4 points.
He's had a good night for the Whitefaces. His indeed. Final time on the floor has been very, very nice. Inbounds from Zevin. He throws it the length of the floor to Kenyon. Ball's knocked away, and it is Perryton's ball. 52 seconds left. Down the floor, three-point shot, good. 63-60, 46 seconds left. Long pass, here we go. Hayden to the bucket, lays it in. 65-50. 38 seconds left. Inbounds now in the backcourt. They throw it away. Hereford's ball. 32 seconds left. A five-point lead. The Whitefaces have this thing under control, I do believe. 65-60. Hereford's basketball. Kenyon to put it in play. In the far corner, he inbounds it to Zevin. Zevin to Kenyon. He shoots a three. It's no good. Rebound, Perryton. 26 seconds left. Perryton, Cervantes shoots a three. It's no good. Rebound, Whitefaces.
Well, I don't know what the call was.
Yeah, I think it was a tie ball.
Was it? Okay.
It is Perryton's
tie ball, Perryton's ball. 20 seconds to play. We lead by five. Perryton will inbound it. They shoot a three. It is good.
Oh, my.
17 seconds left. A two-point game. Ty's got it. Back to Kenyon. 13 seconds left. Whiteface is content to use this time. Long ahead now. 7 seconds left. Back to Ty. 4 seconds left. Off to Kenyon. Kenyon's foul with 1 second left. Perryton ran out the clock without committing a foul, and the Whitefaces will shoot two with 1.7 to play. The shooter is Kenyon. The Whitefaces 1.7 seconds away. A two-point lead in overtime.
Kenyon Loftus to shoot two. Kenyon steps to the line. The first one up, it's good. 66-63. He can make it impossible here with the second one, although with 1.7 seconds. Pretty impossible as it is. He missed it. Rebound, Perryton. Midcourt, they shoot it. It is no good. 66-63. The White Panthers have beaten Perryton in overtime here tonight. And a tough, tough ball game. Teams exchange handshakes here at midcourt. Perryton had a chance to win it in regulation and didn't. And then in this overtime, the Rangers just kept battling back, made a couple of threes down the stretch that were just huge, and the Whitefaces get the victory, 66-63. And my goodness, how hard it was.
We kind of thought that at the beginning of the game, didn't we, that this could come down to
you said
the
exactly
last
that.
Deal, and oh my gosh.
Whitefaces, well, what a night. Well, let's look at the totals, Coach, what you got for us here tonight.
Well, for the Whitefaces, you said, well, it goes, Evan Gonzalez with a good night. He did 21 points on the night for Zevin, 11 points for Ty Duque, 9 for both Hayden Gonzalez and for Diego Villegas, 5 points for Jaden Fletcher, and 3 points for Brandon Gonzalez, Dayton with a couple. So, what a huge night. Oh, my goodness.
Well, the win gives Hereford 6 wins against 7 defeats. We go to Borger next Tuesday night and can not have to worry about anything with a win there, but really Perryton's got Kenyon left, and Whitefaces find themselves in a pretty good position here. And Coach Loftus, 71-year-old Coach Loftus.
Oh, man, I'm 90, man. These guys are making me – I mean, I got so much gray right now.
Well, Coach, what a night. And give Perryton credit. Man, they battled long and hard. They did. And Cervantes, 32 points for him.
We that dude's a player.
He is.
He's a player, and we had no clue to how to stop him.
He had 32 of their 63 points. So,
golly.
Pretty good night for that young man. Great night, final time out here tonight for Zevin. He had 23, I think, to lead us. And it puts us now in a position, Coach. We're 6-7 and virtually assured of the fourth-place finish in the district. I don't think there's a way. I think we are assured.
We beat them twice.
Right,
We're in. We're fourth place, and I'm just glad to make the playoffs.
Yep. Well, here tonight, Coach, we got that 12-point lead in the third quarter, and then again, here came Cervantes. That was he kind of turned it around for them in the second half as he had the first half.
Yeah, we had a game plan, and like the guys just lose their heads when they get out there and can't remember what we're supposed to do on that kid. And you know, it's just one of those things that hey, it's a learning experience.
Yeah.
We're gonna play good guys, and we get to the playoffs, so it's a learning experience.
That's our 20th win of the season. As I said, we're 6-7 in the district going to Borger on Tuesday night. But talk a little bit. I mean, Coach, it's been a tough season. We've had a lot of things go on in the course of the season, and we battled through that adversity, but it's been hard on everybody.
It has. First game back from Christmas break, we lose Butter for 4 games, and he was part of our core. He keeps us going a little bit on defense, and he's the leader. And so not having him, and then we had a couple games where other starters had to sit out. And so, I mean, the past 4 games we've had our whole team, and it feels like we're getting there.
Yeah. We played, I mentioned during the broadcast, not the 3 games we lost to West Plains, Randall, and Kenyon. I mean, we played great basketball in all 3 of those games and got beat 3 times.
Yes, sir. We played it came down to us scoring the ball in those 3 games. We couldn't score. It was just we played hard on defense, but if you can't put the ball in the basket, you're not going to win games.
Yep. Well, what this does, though, is assure us of playing Seminole now in the playoffs. We still have Borger left to go to on Tuesday night.
Yes.
But then the rest of that week off, and then the next Monday, Tuesday, play Seminole.
Most likely Tuesday. I've talked to him already, and Tuesday, we're thinking maybe Friendship. So we'll take care of Borger first.
Yeah,
and
sure.
We'll start looking for Seminole.
Okay. Well, Coach Loftus, congratulations again. I know it's a tough job over there on the bench and a lot going on, and
a lot of excitement out on the floor, and the bottom line is we won, and that's what we needed to do.
Yes, sir.
All right. Congrats, Coach.
Thank you.
Coach Loftus joining us after the game as what was going to be an early night is anything but an early night. We play up here till nearly 9 o'clock on a game that we started at 6:30 this evening. We were supposed to start at 6:30. We obviously didn't do that. But on the night, the Whitefaces, again, the final home night for these seniors, 21 points for Zevin Gonzalez in his last timeout. He's joined out there. Kenyon wound up with 7 points on the night and a big three there late. He couldn't find the range, but he found it late. Hayden Gonzalez had 9, played some good defense, and just played solid basketball. Ty had 11, played his usual game out there tonight. And the Whitefaces, we did a good job at the free throw line, but honestly, Cervantes for them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. He was 10 out of 10 at the free throw line. And then he had 11 buckets to go with that for 32 points. Their next high guy was Rigdon with 8. And he made a couple of threes in the ball game to give him part of those 8 points. But the bottom line is the Whitefaces win and go to 6-7. And onward and upward. Now, we're on the air next on Monday night. That's when the ladies go down to Lubbock Christian, and we'll play on Monday night against Seminole, the district champs down that way. The guys here tonight have assured themselves of a meeting with the district champs Seminole boys in about a week and a half from now at some place to be determined, but perhaps a friendship. But here tonight, everybody got their money's worth, and then some, with the overtime win, 66-63. The Whitefaces over Perryton. That's going to do it for Coach Kitten and I here tonight. For all your Whiteface sports sponsors, this is Tom Simon saying thanks for joining us, and we'll see you Monday night with Lady Whiteface basketball.
Tonight's game is brought to you by the Hereford brand, Capital Farm Credit, Amarillo College, Gooden Fuels, First Bank Southwest,